Configurable consolidation rules with partner eliminations enable you to write data directly to a sibling of the entity currently being consolidated, if the sibling is its intercompany partner, or if one of the sibling's descendants is its intercompany partner. In the example, US Holding has an investment in Company A, its sibling, recorded in the Investments in Subsidiaries account, with Company A as the intercompany partner member. Using partner elimination, the value in the Investment in Subsidiaries account for US Holding is written to the Investment Link account with Company A as the target entity and US Holding as the intercompany partner member. You can apply a factor and a processing option of add or subtract. Partner eliminations are written to the partner eliminations member in the data source dimension. Note that if the intercompany partner is a descendant of a sibling rather than a sibling, the data is written to the sibling, not to the descendant. In this example, US Holding and Company B are siblings, and Canadian Operations is a descendant of Company B. In the data record being consolidated for US Holding, Canadian Operations is the intercompany partner. In this case, the data is written to the sibling, Company B, as the target entity, rather than to its descendant, with US Holding as the intercompany partner. Partner elimination rules require that the ownership management with partner elimination option is enabled for your business process. The entities in the rule scope must be intercompany entities, and the sibling entity being written to, or one of the sibling's descendants, must be the intercompany partner of the entity being consolidated. The accounts included in partner elimination rules do not need to be intercompany accounts, and a plug account is not required. You create configurable consolidation rules on the Consolidated tab of the Consolidation Process page. Before you can add partner elimination rules to a configurable consolidation rule set, the rule set must be enabled for partner elimination. I'll enable the Investments in Sub Holding rule set for partner eliminations. Enabling partner eliminations adds the entity, intercompany, and data source dimensions to the rule set scope. Redirection of the target members for these dimensions is required for partner elimination rules. The sibling descendant of a sibling keyword for the intercompany dimension limits the scope to siblings of the entity being consolidated or descendants of its siblings. I'm finished updating the rule set, so I'll click Save and Close. I'll add a rule to the rule set that writes the value in the holding company's investment in subsidiaries account to the investment link account in the subsidiary, applying the consolidation percentage as a factor. I'll click Redirect Members, and then Enable Partner Elimination. Enabling Partner Elimination adds the source POV intercompany keyword as the target redirection for entity. This redirects the target for the entity dimension to the intercompany partner entity of the source. The source POV entity keyword is added as the target redirection for intercompany. This redirects the target for the intercompany dimension to the source entity member. The data source member is redirected to partner eliminations. The account dimension redirection defaults to same as source, which in this rule is the investment in sub account. I'll redirect to the investment link account. The factor is set by the rule set to the current entity consolidation percentage. I can select Add or Subtract as processing options. I'll select Subtract. My partner elimination rule is complete, so I'll click Save and Close to save my changes. Note that you must deploy the rule set before the rule becomes active.